Hi, I'm Dr. Leela Mohan. I'm an MD physician. I practice at Motherhood, Columbia, Asia as a consultant. I have my own practice, that is Padithem Healthcare, which is in HSR layout, Bangalore. I mainly practice diabetes and other chronic elements. Diabetic foot is nothing but is a complication of diabetes, which mainly caused due to peripheral neuropathy. Peripheral neuropathy is nothing but tingling sensation and numbness of the foot. Peripheral neuropathy is a complication of diabetes. If the sugar levels are not under control, they'll have a complication. This complication is nothing but we'll call it as microvascular complication. So when we come to the diabetic foot is nothing but, as already I had told, the patient will not feel the sensation over the foot. That means when they are landing on the foot on the ground, they won't perceive it. They completely have a numbness and loss of sensation over it. That means they will not come to know where they are placing the leg. If example, as a normal person, if I climb a mountain, I know that I'm climbing on mountain. Or if I'm climbing, or if I'm putting my step on a thorn, we know that I'm putting my step on the thorn. But in the diabetic people who develops this peripheral neuropathy and diabetic foot, they will not come to know that they are placing their foot on the thorn. So now what happens? Because of this thorn, or let it be whatever, on the road a patient is walking, all those things. So the patient will develop a small ulcer or a wound. Because of the diabetes, which is not under control, that wound will not heal as in a normal person. So because this wound is not getting healed, they develop an infection. The infection can lead to even fever and certain other conditions also. And because of the development of an ulcer, the patient will develop a gangrene. A gangrene is nothing but a dead tissue where it has to be amputated or cleared if the patient is not giving an idea about that. So how do we prevent? As already I had told, we lose the loss of sensations and numbness over the foot all the time. So patients should always wear foam chappals or shoes. So usually we avoid barefoot walking, and we should always guide the patients to not to go on the barefoot outside, even at home also. If they wear chappals which is very smooth or which is foamy based, and when they step out or they go for walking, if they wear the full shoes, will definitely help in preventing these complications. And regular checkups with the doctor, like whenever they go for 3 months on an average sugar checkups to the doctor, the diabetic foot has to be examined and then it has to be checked. And there are certain things like you can dip your legs in the warm water with the salt in the bucket. All certain things, small things you can do at home will definitely prevent your diabetic foot.